Olga is here again with the part 5 of the Bitmoji series. In this video, we are going to be building Lens with your and your friend's Bitmoji. So it's gonna be fun. Let's start with installing or updating several useful custom components, such as Bitmoji 3D, Friends component, Friends carousel, Bitmoji stickers and selfies, and UI button. Let's start with adding Friends component to the scene, as well as Bitmoji stickers and selfies. Those are going to be providing some APIs required in our experience. Next, let's add a new screen transform that will create an orthographic camera we need, rename it to Friends Carousel, and add a corresponding component to it. As soon as you do that, you may notice some error messages in the logger that ask us to set Friends Carousel inputs. So let's set them with the two components we have added earlier. Once inputs are set, we can see visuals on the screen that we can interact with. Next step would be to adjust the screen transform. Set screen region on the parent object to the safe render, so our UI does not conflict with the Snapchat UI. Then double-click on the carousel object to open screen transform editor and move the rectangle to the bottom of the screen. Yet, save some space for the button. Now we can get to the scripting part. Let's go and create a new JavaScript file and call it Lens Logic. Then create an input of a script component type, since every custom component you install from Asset Library is actually a script. Let's call this input Friends Carousel. This way, we connect the Friends component to our script and can access its functions. If you're new to scripting, let's check out the documentation website. It's also useful to have the API reference page handy. Drag the newly created script to the scene and set the input. Please note that I have my Lens Logic script at the very end of the object hierarchy. That will make sure all the API functions I will be using are defined by the time I need to call them. Now, let's add a couple lines of code. Script, Friends Carousel, on item selected, add on item selected function. And define the function. Function on item selected. And let's just print the index. Print script.friendsCarousel.getSelectedIndex. How do I know about these functions? I took a look at the component description and noticed that there is an event in the component API that allows me to add callback to it. If you want to learn about this event class, please check out the events module in the asset library. Once we save our code and swipe the carousel, we can see logs printed out the friends index. Let's see if we can have more information about the selected user. Let's add another input for the Friends component. Now plug it in and continue editing our code. I would like to get a list of friends from this component. If I look at the description, there is a specific function for that called friends. Let friends equals script.friendsComponent.friends. And let's print that out. The only catch is it is an asynchronous function. It means when we call it, we won't get the value we need on the next line. You may notice instead of printing out a list of friends, we actually see a promise object. Let's fix this by adding the await keyword and wrapping all this code into an asynchronous init function. I will also move the definition of friends variable outside to be able to access it from another place in my code. Now we can actually see a list of Snapchat user objects printed out. Take a quick peek on this class's API and add a for each loop to print their names. Suite. Now we have an index and a list of users. Now let's add another screen transform and add UI button to it. Adjust button on the screen and make sure we can interact with both components. Then also hook it up to our script via script input. And similarly, use one of the available button events, add callback to it, and add a logger message. Looks like we have all the UI ready and we can start setting up Bitmoji avatars of current user and their friends. Vernon has kindly provided me with the animation that includes three people exported through three different GLB files. Let's import each one to the asset browser and add them to the scene. Following instructions from the previous videos, I'll navigate to the animation player component in the children and add Bitmoji 3D component to the same scene object. I'll adjust the scale and also parent this object to camera according to my concept. First, Bitmoji will be downloaded automatically and will use the current user's avatar. I will repeat the process two more times with the only difference. I'll disable the auto-download checkbox. We will download this from the script. As you know, Bitmoji assets are downloaded at runtime, and the more Bitmoji you have, the longer it will take to initialize the lens. In order to avoid a lag, it is recommended to distribute Bitmoji loading in time. To accommodate this, I have designed the next flow. I want to display the carousel and the button that says Select First Friend. Once the button is clicked, the first Bitmoji is downloaded, and when it's done, the button should change to Select Second Friend. So let's get to scripting. Let's hook up two of the friend's Bitmoji components to our script. Input, component, script component, friend Bitmoji 1. Input, component, script component, friend Bitmoji 2. And also add an index variable to control which friend we are downloading. That index equals to 0. And add another couple lines in the on button pressed callback. So now we have to pass in our first selected friend. As you remember, we have disabled auto download on the first Bitmoji. And now we will use a download avatar for user API function. Again, you can find all this either on documentation website or in the component description. So if index equals to 0, let first friend, friend's selected index, then script friend's Bitmoji 1, download avatar for user, and pass in first friend. Let's see how that works. Don't forget to plug in the Bitmoji 1 and Bitmoji 2. And you should be able to see the first friend now. Now, let's add some logic when the first friend's Bitmoji is ready. To do so, we need to go back to the init function and add a callback. Script Friends Bitmoji 1 on Downloaded at on Bitmoji Downloaded and define this function. Function on Bitmoji Downloaded, and here we're just going to increment the index. Once we do that, we can go back to the button callback and provide the new branch in our logic. If index equals to 1, script friend bitmoji 2 download avatar for user, and similarly pass in the user. At this point of time, we can disable our UI. So let's do next. Script friends carousel scene object enable equals to false, and same for the button. Nice. Let's tweak our UI a little so it reflects the logic. I will save the reference to the UI button's text component and set button text in two places. I will also add a setUIEnabled function to prevent users from clicking again when assets are still loading. I will call this function from several places with different arguments to reflect land state. We can continue polishing the lens with adding a school background, shadows, etc. So to recap, in this video, we have connected several useful custom components and implemented asynchronous user flow. Let us know if there is anything else you want to learn. Happy creating!